Introducing One Lion, designed for a royal shave.
Welcome to L.O.T.E. Wrestling with your boy Ring. You heard. Happy Mondays. It is the Monday before WrestleMania 40, and I am tuned in. That's why I keep looking back. But I've been watching the whole thing since it started. When The Rock came out, everything was lit. Bear with me. Roman acknowledged him as the final boss.
He's not fit for these shoes. He's not fit for leadership. I told you guys, he's a politician.
See, Roman's saying everything I've been saying. Cody's a politician. Nobody, yo. Told y'all Cody's a politician.
Take me off the top of the mountain. My children can't have that. You know, so those children can't have that. The final boss is
Seth Rollins. Seth's best way to get at Roman mentally is like, he gotta do the Shield entrance, I swear. First hour, commercial free. Yo, somebody is mad loud in the crowd.
We got your back.
Seth Rollins wants to fight The Rock. Let's see if he says The Rock. I knew it was coming. Look at The Rock's face, like. Everybody saying Rocky.
They want to see The Rock in action. Beat that boy so bad he got brain damage. I'm dead. Yo, Roman's expression, man. Solo. Knew it. Got a plan for Solo giving him all these promos now. That's the enforcer, though. He said stipulations if you want it, brother. You asked for it. This is an example of what Bloodline Rules is going to be.
She told me to ignore it.
Yeah.
since your WrestleMania 40 opponent, Rhea Ripley, would you care to comment on what happened?
Well, I'm here tonight to finish what I started, so I will be out in that ring later if Rhea cares to answer the call.
Becky Lynch and Rhea Ripley. Becky looked tight though.
Don't mention her daughter.
Just in case you ever wonder if I'm actually doing something, yeah. I really am. I don't just sit here and watch. I'm actually doing edits at the same time and all that. I got some other people, so I gotta put them in the universe. If I can remember who they are. I want to copy and paste this universe, but I want to wait till I fill it up with characters and all that.
Gargano able to counter, tag
the largest domestic gate in the history of Monday Night Raw here tonight.
That's huge.
Yeah, that's the history of Raw.
I don't remember how much people I got. I remember earlier.
Welcome, welcome, welcome in. YouTube. Looks really good.
Watch Jungle Run for the next 20 minutes. Yeah, tremendous stamina. Supreme athlete. No limits to his ability. As Ciampa's taking out the judge today. Dirty Dom and J.D. McDonough. That's a beautiful sight to see. Just one person clobbering the judgment day. Dom Dom and J.D. McDonough gone. And Kofi Kingston directed traffic. Damian Priest now into the next building. The Ciampa. Kofi Kingston out. Top off. Kofi takes out Priest. And Kofi, the legal man, in this matchup for his team.
Kofi Kingston, former world champion.
Yeah, Kofi, the maniac. The one WrestleMania moment for the new AOPAS corresponding lateral press. Kofi Lake and a kick out.
Welcome, welcome, welcome in Facebook and YouTube. Here chilling, watching Monday Night Raw, Monday before WrestleMania. Let's get it. Ever took a hit and got hot? Holy crap. That's some fire. Whoa. Want to make sure I got everybody in there. I think it was three. I'm not sure. I feel like it was four. I need another female to add to. I see Damian Priest as a future champion, though, like, only because you have all these top names there right now that it backtracks these people, but when these people go, I can see Damian Priest winning the championship. I think he deserves it, too. He gets mad W's, he gets mad pins. At the end of the day, he does win a lot, and he does know how to make other people look good. Yeah.
You're welcome, Les, man. Hit me up if you need anything. Got you. Congratulations, buddy.
Thank you so much, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, for those of you who don't understand, what you've just learned is that the tribal chief will induct the wise man into the Hall of Fame this Friday.
Were Roman inducting Paul Heyman? I see that, though. I see that. I would have thought CM Punk, since he was like one of the first Paul Heyman guys, but I can see why Roman would do it too. Like, if he's going to retire, quote unquote, after WrestleMania, if he loses the title, I think he would want to retire on that high note too. So Roman's trying to retire on a high note, being the champion, being top of the mountain. I think they're going to, I don't know, I feel like they're going to make it sentimental in a certain way. Like, they're not just going to send him off. But he's also supposed to just take time off and then, like, return in, like, a year or something, too. So, I think it all depends on what he's going to do in his future. So, the decision is ultimately up to Roman. See, a lot of us knew that Chad Gable would have been the one to train Sammy in a certain way how to beat Gunther. See this movie scene? Like, this is an actual movie scene, like, between Chad Gable and Sami Zayn. Like, this is like a movie, bro. This is why I call this era the cinematic era, because everything is shot in movie form. Like, they draw the attention a specific way with the camera angles, the close-up, the speaking, what they're saying in general. Like, it's personal. At times, they kind of make you feel like, hey, I've been in that position. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're smart as hell. What you needed to hear. It's a typical movie, bro. Like, for a split second, I was like, that shit pulled my emotions in there. Like, yo, what the fuck? What makes me laugh, and this is why I watch the product. Like I said, there's an art to wrestling. Like, now they're learning the art of acting. Like, they're all learning to meet. Like, I feel like they're learning acting on the side somewhere. I feel like The Rock introduced Hollywood a specific way to WWE.
this is where the storylines will get better, because they will have better Hollywood type storylines, sentimental storylines, storylines that actually draw in the crowd. Not just, oh, somebody's theme music. What's the story behind these people? What's the story of why these people are going so hard for this championship? Like, this is what they're doing, and it's all creating new art for wrestling. It's sports entertainment. This is not Olympic wrestling. This is not like the official go to high school. No, this is sports entertainment. This is about who is a star. What can you do to become a star? It's not easy to be a star. You can be a star today and lose it tomorrow. It's hard to be a star and continuously be a star. Look how much time that Roman tried in the beginning, and he couldn't get to that level in people's eyes. This is why on WWE Legends, and he was so hurting that WrestleMania or SummerSlam, whatever the case may be, when he won the Rocky Mountain, he got booed. It's hard to be a star and stay a star. It's hard to stay relevant. If you're doing the same thing every day, in and out, all the time, it becomes less special. So Cody Rhodes winning every week, every other week getting beat up, it kind of loses the specialness. That's why I say he's going to turn heel. He's a secret heel. And when they use the heel part, now it's going to be like, oh snap, Cody's wild. But how much of an impact will that be? Who is a star? Is Cody a star? I don't see Cody as a wrestling star.
Extras for now. I gotta put them on the Tuesday show.
Just $15 each for two lines of unlimited. Call, click, or visit. C'est le plus grand WrestleMania de tous les temps. Voyez ça comme ça. Si vous gagnez, vous deviendrez le plus grand champ de toute l'histoire.
Lance le match. The road to WrestleMania is untouched. This year, one thing's for sure.
Although I took off automatic rivals, it does still does its own rivalries. It's so weird.
Oh damn, you can simulate up to these matches now? That's crazy. Dominic is wild.
Talk to me next time. Anyways, you can be friends.
They all from Dominic. Me, Judgment Day. Mommy, JD, Fig. Touch me. Hey,
yeah, don't touch me. Dominic trying to make it a hangout. You better get out of here with that guy, bro. Let's see if he can breed Bronson Reed now.
Traits. I will say, Brunson much more wide. Terry Hall, 330 pounds. Bonsa just is wilding in the chopping. Sami Zayn continues on the attack in the corner.
The training show, that's why I set it up like that. So like the last three matches are the three people I got earlier. So I just wanna see what they do.
Respect?
Why not? Shake their hand. There we go. That's how we need to start a matchup.
All right, now that pleasantries have been exchanged, let's tear each other apart.
Didn't realize my thing was a lie.
Well, I appreciate true sportsmanship.
Well, this match has started, and you always love to see that mutual appreciation before the bell.
That kind of respect is something that can take a superstar to the next level in their career.
Oh, come on, Saxton. In WWE, you gotta hit first, or you'll be the one getting hit. calf smash.
Ooh, what a moonsault.
Coming there.
Oh, what a kick.
Oh, kick right to the back.
Punch to the stomach connects.
Boom.
How disrespectful, my gosh. See ya.
And will this be it? And he doesn't let the pin last long at all.
Just powered out.
Springboard off.
These are just my jobbers in a match. First match, just jobbers.
Okay, he's re-entering the ring. Knee to the midsection. Bang to the neck. Cinches up the arm and a
vicious kicks to the jaw.
I think rage took over in that moment. Nothing but blind rage.
And the forearm smash. He's channeling the crowd's energy. Escape just in time.
Oh, kick right to the back. Boom, stop, stop, stop. Ooh, the forearm connects. Oh, launching himself from the ropes. Is it enough? And he breaks the count quickly.
He's not letting fatigue set in or get the better of him.
He's begging him to get up so he can put him back down.
No way.
Somersault plancha to the floor. It's like a heat-seeking missile coming at you.
And the explosion occurring ringside.
Brought back into the ring from the floor now. Shoulders are down. Power right out in one.
Got to change something up with the pin technique.
Right to the gut.
He may be in a bad way here. And hanging tough, but beginning to show some wear and tear. Might want to think about picking up the pace a bit.
Cover! Two. No, stops the count.
Almost inhuman at this point.
The superstar building incredible momentum.
Oh, I mean, this is, I don't know how the superstar is doing it. Down and out, moments ago, back in it now. Shot to the midsection connects.
Ouch. Got him up.
Into the neck breaker. Uh-oh. And he's able to counter. Outside countouts legal in this match. Oh, geez. Nasty kick to the face. Oh, that'll cave your chest in. He's in a little bit of trouble now.
Well, all things considered, Cole, it's not a bad condition to be in at this point in the match.
Ooh.
Both arms captured, and vitriolic stops. The stop in every single part of his body.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. Running a little small show. It's the training show. It's the Tuesday show. I remixed the NXT. Got a couple new characters, and I'm watching Raw. I'm watching Sami Zayn, seeing if the work is paid off. No worries, though. I'm here. I'm chilling. You can tune in to Monday Night Raw and see The Rock and Roman Reigns and Seth Rollins.
Man, oh, man. What resilience. He's got to be running on instinct alone. I can see it in the eyes from here. Disbelief. Unbelievable how this one is still going on. No backing down here. They really want to make sure the best man comes out on top in this one. Oh, a nasty stop to finish it off. Looking for the victory. Two count. Stopping the refs count at two. That is just pure instinct at this point.
You know, I rarely seen Gunther run up on somebody like this, but is that a sign that he's going to lose that title to Sam? He just picked Sammy up and that kind of looked like a pause.
There's a great victory.
Talk about being a great ass heel. Gunther was not played.
It's hard to criticize someone when they embody that level of respect.
Yeah, he's ready for heavyweight championship time. Gunther gotta move up. Gunther's ready, bro. Oh my God, Sammy with the overselling with this. Flopping like a fish, man. Chad Gable's starting to finally move. Funny as hell. I call this era of WWE the cinematic era. I am the first to say it. I don't know if anybody else said it, but that's what I've been calling it. Since Roman Reigns and the Bloodline story, everything has been angles with the camera, the emotion that they pull you in with the stories. Just watch how they shoot a lot of stuff. It's all in the camera angles. Even when Logan Paul caught Randy Orton in Elimination Chamber with the brass knuckle. That was out of nowhere. Like, the camera was, he wasn't even in the frame. Like, they're smart now. This is all cinematic shit. I call this the cinematic era. There is an art to wrestling, and WWE is putting it on a different level. I watch AEW, but they're more of an ECW style wrestler. They don't have the storylines yet. That's why they hired an ex-WWE person to make their storylines a little bit better. But when you have people like Will Ospreay, like not much people could work with Will Ospreay. If you don't know who Will Ospreay is, he is totally different. He's totally unique. Like, he does some incredible shit in the ring. I'd be like, get the fuck out of here, bro. Who's thinking about this? He is. Like, you gotta put him as, like, Dusty Rhodes. Like, Roman Reigns. Like, he's only an attraction. You can't pull him out every week. He is like that Joker card. Like, you only flip that shit when necessary. You can't promote him too much. He could be off screen, keep him in the limelight, but you can't have him in the ring all the time because not many people could keep up with him. But everything WWE doing right now is mad cinematic. It's a freaking movie shoot. And I swear to God, I feel like all of them are learning acting on the side somewhere because that's where it's coming into play. You got to know how to play the role, feel the emotion of that character and bring it in. This way he draws the us into it. That's why we're so interested in everything, because it's so dramatic. It's not like Attitude Era, it's that Attitude Era feeling because of the language and what they're doing, but this is cinematic. Even the Becky Lynch with the Rhea Ripley, like, that was cinematic.
I listen to a lot of podcasts now, so I listen to like 83 Weeks. I listen to Vince Russo and all that, and they all got their points. But at the end of the day, I think I even wrote in their chats like, I call this the cinematic era of wrestling. This is what they're doing. That's why they're going to Netflix. It's going to be mad dramatic. It's going to be different. And I think The Rock has a lot to do with that, pulling Hollywood into it, like mixing all those, like, oh, let's make this a damn movie. Let's make it interesting again.
We are about to see something good.
As long as they don't have Cody and everybody bleeding every week, they'll be good. Because you don't need the blood every week. That's when you know it becomes real personal. Blood, like, it's personal, but sometimes accident happens, like they hit their nose or something. That's why sometimes you Bronson Reed with a bloody nose like last week. But those are like accidents. So you kind of know the difference. But the way Cody was bleeding, you could tell that the way they shot that, it was like a movie scene of somebody getting their ass kicked. I think it's fire how they're doing it. They can, like, not every story is going to be the top story like that, but they can make all the other segments kind of like that, just on a smaller scale, until it gets to that level. I think that's how they're going to start building the stars.
Non-title match here with a superstar cementing themselves as a champion to watch. But they say winning a title takes you to another level. That certainly has been the case here.
But to me, it's more about what happens after WrestleMania. What's going to happen there? What's going to happen
after?
I'm a big Travel Chief fan.
While he's been on fire lately, his success might be considered a fluke. This non-title match is definitely going to be.
So it's like, what happens to the bloodline if, when he does leave? Like, does Jay and Jimmy get back together? Like, you know what I mean? Like, I've been saying they need to get back together, and that's eventually going to happen. Like, you need the Usos, bro. Even their segments was fire. The Uso Penitentiary, that shit was fire. Like, those are characters you can relate to. I keep telling everybody, like, I've been saying it even before they started saying it. Cody Rhodes is a freaking politician, and then all of a sudden they start saying, I'm telling you. Man is a politician, bro. Hell yeah. The man shakes everybody's hand after the show for an hour, bro. Nigga, you trying to get votes, bro. I'm telling you. He's a heel. That's why he dresses like that.
And when he gets your vote and he's in that seat, what happens? Now they come with that ruthless power. Like, now they come with the bad shit. Like, that's what it is. Don't be surprised if Cody Rhodes wins that title and eventually turns heel. Because it's going to get boring being the face.
But the thing is, Cody Rhodes doesn't... It's hard to even connect to Cody as a heel sometimes.
Because he doesn't... Roman just doesn't fit.
When Roman turns a heel, like, the way he dresses in his hoodies, the sweats, all the merch, like, he comes with a style and a flow you could connect with. Like, you know, he's a regular dude up the street, I feel that. Like, he comes with the Jordans, you know what I mean? Like, bro, my man comes with a vest, a suit, pocket watch, ready to wrestle. Bro, you're not coming to see me, you're coming to get my taxes, bro. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, I can't connect with Cody. The American Nightmare should be a different type of personality. The American Dream is more of a face, like a superhero. The American Nightmare is more of a supervillain. It's like kind of hidden in the name. I think this match is starting to take its toll.
Off the rope. And he's really gotten into his zone right now. He's gaining the upper hand here.
I don't know. Cody just wants to be a champion. I mean,
Cody's like, I just want to be the champion. That's it. Cover, cover.
Kick out it wide. He's going to take this match as long on as far as he needs to. Big boot. The damage he's taken is starting to pile up.
Team
when his guard is down. Countered it just in time. Whatever's planned here can't be good. Unmitigated demonstration of power. I've seen Saxon thrown out of a few local bars like that before.
Please don't remind me, Corey.
Yo, Candice LeRae, bros. Yo, funny as hell, bro.
Dangerous position here, guys.
Oh, no.
Suplex. What do you need to do?
Suplex on the apron. The inner name for the apron, unless you're looking to do some serious damage. And another. Just going all out with every blow.
Flipping senton.
Indy Hartwell needs to just snuff Candice, like, hold that bit.
Letting his opponent know he can take on the world right now.
This could be big, going up high.
He has a right where he wants him.
From the top.
What? Coming down on their opponent like a sack of bricks.
He takes control. Handle.
Got wrestling next to me, wrestling to the other side.
Oh my God, he foiled that attempt.
Thank you for joining me on my Monday Night Raw schedule.
Here it comes. Hooked up. And nice.
Appreciate your company.
Suplex. And the cover for the win. This is it.
I just like to find characters off of comedic creations and book them.
I'm seeing right now. No one can.
So I'm in the process of building the universe.
Boom, right to the body. He's struggling a bit here.
At this stage of the match, they are clearly starting to feel the effects of this back and forth.
He may get the three count right here. This is it. And only gets a one count.
Shows that this is still anybody's match at this point.
Shot connects. Turned that one around. Next stretch. This is how you punish your opponent, and he's enjoying every minute of it. And he gets delivered back into the ring. Oh my God, that's gotta hurt. The end is looming now. I don't want to say he's done, but I can hear the fat lady warming up. Oh, an overhand punch.
Uh-oh.
He's one step ahead there.
I mean, now he's fired, though.
Great counter.
Perched on the shoulders. Feast your eyes. Opportunity is his for the taking.
Cover. Shit, that looked like a stiff ass kick. Kicked it right in the chest.
I'm pretty sure everyone in the building thought that was going to be the end of it, myself included. I think there's still some shock in the air over the fact that that didn't produce a pinfall. This is not going to be good.
Relentless.
Come on, Andy, snuff.
And a stomp to the gut, too.
And the wrong side of things for him to be on there.
Deep wow, can he get us all the whole thing out there?
Sure, European uppercut.
Oh, a blow to the breadbasket.
Talk about giving away for Maxine to get a win.
I think we know it's about to happen.
Cervical clutch applied.
It's cinched in. I think we're just...
It's over. Brutality finally comes to an end. Here is your winner, Josh Poussin. You cannot say
she said you lost to Maxine Dupree.
Achieve this victory. The reward definitely seems greater than the risk right about now.
You should be ashamed of yourself.
They feel once they get back to the locker room and hit the showers.
Like, Candice LeRae kind of set that up for her to get pinned by Maxine. Like, you could kind of tell. I can see Indy snuffing Maxine, though. You can tell that's about to happen. Yo. Solo's talking a little bit more in promos. I've been saying it. Like, watch, like, I think 2 weeks ago I said Solo needs to talk more in his promos. All of a sudden, the man talking more in the promos. He would be hating on Roman. They don't understand why he do what he do. Solo did. Roman did a lot to bring up everybody. He brought up Solo. He brought up Jimmy and Jay a little bit better. Like, he came with the fire shit, bro. And when I say brought up, I don't mean he introduced. Like, they kind of introduced him into the game, but he got to a level where he was like, yo, they gotta come up with me. And that's what he did, bro. He said, now, if I get this come up, they can come up with me. And that's why his family above all. Like, there's reasons of why Roman does what he does. People be hating, like, oh, he's a part-timer. Like, do y'all not understand WWE gave him the contract because he wanted to leave? A while back, like he been wanted to drop this title, but they didn't want to lose the merchandise. Like, they didn't want to lose their face of their company because they have nobody to be the face of. Like, he was the face of their company. That's why he was groomed for the position. Like, there's reasons. Even he had to, like, find himself. Like, it's not easy. trying to find that perfect character that connects with everybody. Like, a lot of people didn't connect with the big dog, because that was Vince's character. Tribal Chief was something that was came up with Paul Heyman, where he saw a movie, and he pointed it out to Roman. Roman saw it, and Roman kind of got that character from it, so that's where the Tribal Chief was introduced. So now the stories became more sentimental. Like, who can't connect with a brother and brother story? You know what I mean? Who can't connect with a family story? And at the end of the day, does family really turn on family? In my eyes, no. Even if it was wrestling, I mean, no. Like, how can you be kicked out of family? Your bloodline. You can't be kicked out of a bloodline. You are a bloodline. It's in your blood. No matter where you are, no matter how you think, you're still that bloodline. It's something that doesn't leave you. So no matter what show you on, Jay, you still bloodline. People always forget. People turn on Roman. Roman don't turn on nobody. Roman don't kick people out like that. He may question, but he don't kick nobody out. People kick themselves out by turning on him. To me, that's Roman's story. A lot of people turn on Roman. Storyline wise, not real. That's the story of the Tribal Chief, if you really think about it. And it actually started with the Big Dog stages with Seth Rollins and The Shield. Seth Rollins was the first. That's his brother, right? They brothers. Seth Rollins was the first. Then you go with Jimmy. Then you got Jay. Then you had Sammy. Then you had Jay again. Everybody was waiting on Solo to turn. Solo's like, nope, you brought me up in here. I'm good. I said the Rock going to turn. No, I don't see the Rock turning on Roman. I've been said that. I don't see why the Rock needs to turn on Roman. That's unnecessary. The match that they want to have is something that they want to have. They don't necessarily need to turn on each other. It doesn't make sense. This is the match the Rock been wanted to have because he's been wanting to put Roman over. So I think that's how he just wanted to solidify Roman's run. That's pretty much the story. I feel like, shoot, in a little way, Rock and Cody got her a little personal. I'm just saying, that's how I see it. There's no reason for The Rock to turn on Roman if they're already going to win the first night. For all that, you could just turn on him that first night. In the same tag match, and then he gets pinned by Cody. That's the only way I can see it happening. You're not gonna pin Cody the first night and then turn around the second night. That don't make sense. You just whooped Cody's ass last week, bro. You ain't turning on Roman right now. According to reports, Roman wanted The Rock to do it. He said The Rock to do it. According to reports. I don't know, I just read the shit.
One of the top names in the entire women's division, and she plans.
But I would have figured that would have been a swerve, even in the storyline, that I would have put in anyway. I sent him to do that. Sent him a message, like some stupid shit. But at the end of the day, it got so personal. The Rock is tight. The Rock is just more mad that he said yes. Okay, I'm gonna let you have the match, and then he came back and said no. This is the most. That's what The Rock is mad about. So now The Rock's taking it personally because the match should have been their match. So, in a way, I feel like The Rock is legitimately like, Cody, fuck your story. Your story is boring. Because when you win the title, what's going to happen?
nothing. You're not interesting enough. To be a big challenge, but if
anyone is up for it, it's this woman. That's how I see it. I like Cody Rhodes. Don't get me wrong. I'm not a big fan, but I know Cody Rhodes. I watch Cody Rhodes. I've seen him in AEW, TNA, WWE, came back to WWE. I've seen it all. I've seen him as a heel before he left AEW. I heard what he had to say as a heel. It still didn't fit. That's why it went over everybody's head, because nobody got it. It was like, oh, you're a heel now? Okay, why? Why? You're like, why are you doing what you do? Like, your character has to come out.
But this match underway, it's worth noting that she's made clear that this is a must-win match. In terms of motivation, there's nobody harder on herself.
Very few people that can say what they're talking about, but she can't connect with that kind of
stuff.
We all have a family somewhere, so that's so sentimental to everyone.
Yeah, but chopping at the bit is a superstar.
People are just mad because they wanted to see the title defended more. But then you get bored of that, too.
It's time for her to make everyone remember just how good she is.
You get bored of that, too. You get bored of seeing the champion every week, every week, every week. You know who's going to win. Until a pay-per-view, most likely. When was the last time we see titles change on a show? Like, it's very rare now. It's always usually at a pay-per-view. So the question is, which pay-per-view? That's all it is.
Enables a counter. Big knee to the midsection. Just mounted with punches and not. Oh, a nasty stomp to finish it off. Up and around, down with a tilt-a-whirl backbreaker. Great display of power. The tip-lift German suplex. That is the kind of
Drew
McIntyre
is doing great work
on the floor. Unbelievable.
Great.
The fatigue is setting in for her. And just like that, pull up out of nowhere. And she breaks free before a one count. Wow.
Like, Drew McIntyre would have better storylines and better action in a way than a Cody Rhodes match.
Savage knee to the face.
I don't know why.
A running knee right between the shoulder blades. Ooh, she responds
with
a counter. Got the knees up. She saw that one coming. Running hurricane. Sometimes you just gotta show off and show out.
I understand Drew McIntyre's story better than I understand Cody Rhodes' story.
Taking it outside.
My man wants to win the title in front of a crowd. He won that shit with the empty arena. That's why he kind of.
Damage to the hamstrings.
Can I win in front of a crowd now?
Man,
I want to be the star. I want to start it. I want to be back on top of the mountain. He's been there for a minute, too.
Clothesline stops that move in its tracks. Saw it coming. Oh, it is over. Just mounted with punches and not. Oh, a nasty stomp to finish it off. Uh oh. Both arms trapped. This will not end well. Rapid fire stops to the back. And any one of those shots could take you out for
listen,
good.
Listen, no matter how in the answers.
Well mentored.
Like close people, bro.
She's in danger of a count out here.
I don't know if she cares.
And it's reverse pain for that mistake. And she was dangerously close to a count out. Horse forearm draped across the middle rope. And down! Look out! Oh, God! Now, that was a harebrained idea to try that.
Was trying to find a way to attack, but completely wiped out.
And the forearm smash! Carefully placed stomp to the arm.
Cuts off their offense. With a swift elbow to the gut.
I can see Ricochet winning a title. I don't know which one. Maybe Logan Paul.
Can you shut yourself
just like she envisioned.
He's underrated right now.
She wins! She wins!
And this victory is one for the record books.
This certainly wasn't an easy win, but she pulled it off.
And in the end, that's all that matters.
Shit. Man, if I fell off a ring like that, I'd be broke, bro. I was not getting up. Hell no. Oh, man. Alright, now we're getting into these new characters. Let's see what they do. They look pretty good, though. First one's my jobber, the second one's a new guy. I usually introduce some new people like that. Go get some jobbers. Sometimes the jobbers win. I'd be shit surprised. Like, what the hell? I'm gonna have to, like, lower their ratings or something. They whooping ass.
And here he comes!
The following is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from New York.
Yeah, when you see Superstar, I just left the templates and just left them at jobbers. They're not that important.
Take a look at the talent in competition here.
This is my minor show, so that's why I see so much.
The WWE Universe is so amped up for this one. He is in perhaps the best shape of his career, and he will need that with the competition level this high.
I think instead of making that logo bigger, I think I might just put it in a tile. I'm gonna try that. My man came in with Matt Hardy delete.
He said he'll steal the show here tonight, and he looks more than ready to deliver on that promise.
Delete. I'm dead. Hardy boys are really coming back for WrestleMania for the ladder match.
While he might be molded, he could still use a little refining. If he can harness that potential, we're looking at the next big thing.
Sure, a little rough around the edges, Corey, but there's something that comes with time and experience.
And he has his work cut out for him here, facing off against someone who feels he's been disrespected lately. Someone who's really come out here with something to prove.
I do not know that I agree he's been disrespected lately, but if he wants respect, it would do him good to win this matchup.
Boot to the gut will stop anyone in their tracks. Dropping the knee for more punishment.
Measured kick to the vertebrae.
Incredible.
Spanish.
Two count. And he powers out.
He thought he had it.
Standing shooting star press. Incredible.
Agility like that. Easier
shoulders in my body be feeling? I don't know how wrestlers be doing it, bro.
Just defenseless as the momentum is against him. Yeah, he's got to surmount this storm coming at him. This could be a tipping point in this match. Oh, no,
you got to be waking her, waking up, throbbing all over your body. At this point. Aches and pains, like, geez.
Big takedown right there. He eludes the contact. Knee to the midsection, and a kick to the back. Ow, bam.
What are you doing?
Perched on the shoulders.
Oh, he's on that.
Does he have a win in hand now? Shoulders down. And he's still in the game. Where in the world is he getting this from? His beating heart will not be stopped. You gotta imagine this match is a different complexion.
You know what I'm saying? My job is to put you
in work. He's absorbed some damage already. Two! No! Two count! How? How? That's mounted with punches and not and a stomp to the gut, too. Was ready for that. Here he goes for the win! Can he close it out? He got the shoulder up in time.
You expect these pins to last much longer at this stage in the match.
Looking worse for wear in the corner now. Bruising attack to the stomach. Right across the back of the neck. Ouch.
If I flipped as much as Ricochet, I would be dizzy as hell.
Ooh. Climbing up top, he's got incoming. You gotta be kidding me. Big time risk pays off. The daredevil in you comes out when you take risks like that. Salina del Sol.
Gotta get him in the ring, buddy.
Oh, here we go.
Amazing display of athleticism. But can they turn that into a win?
And he tosses him back in there. Cover. An exhausting match, but a victory he'll savor forever.
Here is your winner, Jushin the Dragon Lee.
A big win, and the celebration has begun.
Every match is special, but this one just raised the bar even higher. I bet the whole locker room was watching this one by the end of it.
Damn. Ivor Muckle needs Muckle. Yo, that was funny as hell just now. Ivor was doing the shake, rattle, and roll. Stop. Damn. Ivor could get up, dude. Surprised that bottom buckle will hold him. I thought that shit would have snapped. Damn. Ricochet caught Ivar, bro, and held him, bro. And then flipped him. I'm telling you, they're prepping Ricochet for a championship, bro. I'm telling you, they're prepping that man for a championship. Yeah. yo, he caught Ivar clean too. Like, he caught that man. Like, gotcha. gotcha. You know his girl is hype right now, Samantha Irvin. Yeah, she hype. She hype to say her man won that man. Pat McAfee was damn. I like Pat McAfee. He be making it hype, bro. He's funny as hell.
Here we go, guys.
This entrance. I heard this one backstage talking up their own work non-stop. Well, why don't they get in the ring and prove it, huh?
That's what they're doing right now, Corey.
Oh, Damian Priest, yeah. Got then. How he got Judgment Day on the sideline while this guy's over there with these other people. Get out of here, you know. Phantasm, Del Phantasm, whatever. Get out of here. Damn, Dominic is bringing in everybody, bro. Dominic is gonna break up Judgment Day, bro. Or just kick him out.
The last time someone got a title match because of their courage and character.
Rhea is tight. Rhea is tight. I'm just saying, that's definitely a good way to break up Judgment Day, because it seems like Dominic's the one breaking it up. They're about to hit him with everybody else been saying, bro, you went to jail for a couple hours, bro. Calm down. Not my boss. Oh, man. Dominic looked like he wanted to make a little LWO group of himself. That's what I thought.
A guy who treats every match as if it's the biggest one of his career.
He's doing what Dominic is to me? He's not impressive in the ring to me. He doesn't impress me. I never like, oh, I gotta see this Dominic. No. I feel like his matches are awkward. I don't know why. Just awkward. Rising.
not too familiar with this one.
What can you tell me about this guy, Corey?
From what I've seen so far, he's been pretty unremarkable for me. I'm not even sure how he ended up in WWE, to be honest with you.
Well, let's hope he uses this match to prove why he deserves to be here.
But don't discount the man he's facing. A man who has been counting the minutes to getting this fight started. Oh my goodness!
Oh, down by the DDT.
I picked this guy because he looked a little offensive. Like he looked like a legit luchador created. This person really likes luchadors. I feel like if I went to Mexico, I'd see like somebody like this guy. That's what I think.
That's playing fast and loose with your own body.
That is weaponizing your body. That's what that was.
Paying it right back with a reversal. Oh, strong impact. Lands the knee drop. Great wherewithal on the counter.
The adrenaline is pumped.
Not allowing that to go on any longer.
Ooh, elbow strike. Oh my gosh, terminating knee smash. Ooh, sharp kick.
Looking to crush the hamstring.
Oh. Another one?
Who won the race? Charlie's horse. That was a vicious display. You can almost see the disdain in their eye. He thinks he has it. And he manages to kick out at one. He's nowhere near ready to stop fighting yet.
Down on the chest.
Whoa, whoa.
Hoist it up.
Suplex! This match's brutality starting to show on him. They've definitely taken their lumps at this point. Their opponent is not messing around.
My man went to old school.
Old school!
Right on the mark.
What are they doing here? Having a weakened arm can limit you in so many ways, making it harder to execute on even simple attacks. Down to Odin and a double axe handle smash. Oh, what a voice!
Yeah, that's some attitude behind.
Oh, look at this! Is it enough, guys?
Job is on the loose.
Get back in this match!
Wow.
So far, so good. Getting carried. Unsure what they're thinking. Tossed around like a rag doll. His defenses have fallen, and soon he may too. At this point, it might be too much for him to recover from, Cole. He's reeling, slowly getting up.
Don't do it. Slingshot, senton. Took a massive risk, but it might have paid off.
Lifting their opponent back to their feet and a thunderous right hand. Punch lands. Oh, God. Outside of the ring now.
What's the plan here?
And this match will head back to the ring.
Oh, man, he has fired up now.
Okay, consider that a harsh lesson. Unloads with the boot.
Oh, she came to talk. Oh, she came to fight.
The arms are uh-oh.
Oh, she just said, I mean, if you're looking for a fight, I'm dead.
Slam.
Leg drop across the throat. He deflects it right back.
I'm not like they could really fight now. They'll be fighting at WrestleMania. Get out of here.
What a crossbody. Does he get him here?
hate security guards.
Cementing their name after that match. Definitely earning those accolades with that win. With a win like that, he just stood up and commanded the attention of everyone in the WWE Universe.
I think they've noticed, Byron.
With a cast on her hand. Yo, you got like 10 security guards for them two girls, bro. That's crazy. You know, they could easily just be like, hey, if you fight now, you get suspended or you lose the title or substitution. Like, it's that easy. And they wanted to do that. Still call themselves Damage Control. I'm just saying. I don't call them Damage Control. Bailey not here. She made them. It's the first WrestleMania doing a solo match one-on-one. She got a win.
It's scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from New York.
She's always in a multi-tag match.
Some would say the superstar thinks a little too much of themselves, but the tape doesn't lie. This is a serious contender for any title. They need to loosen up, have a little fun, maybe even lose a match once in a while.
That is horrible advice.
Goddamn, we need to stop this. These are yellow brackets for my ears. So rare. I didn't know what was my allergy.
And his opponent from the Bronx, New York, weighing in at 241 pounds. The Chosen One, Steven Gould.
The WWE Universe delivering quite a reaction. Perhaps the most highly anticipated match of the night.
Brand new debut.
Thank you.
This is a match he's craved for quite some time. He's ready and raring to go.
The main event on the training ship. That is usually the NXT one.
One of the most fearless and determined superstars on the roster today.
Certainly determined. We'll see if all that buzz around him is warranted tonight.
But he'll be taking on an individual who is turning a lot of heads as of late. He's gained a level of popularity that is steadily growing week by week. And he wants to prove that the hype is legitimate.
And will this be it? No, he kicks out.
He's not even close to being done yet. Six.
Oh, to the arm. Terrible. Pat, that one's scouted. Side rush and leg sweep. Takedown, and these will keep you down.
Just never had a chance to block any of those.
He had it scouted. Oh, man. Horrifying DDT. Yes, he didn't come here to watch him boast and taunt. And the forearm smash. Brutal stomp to the body. And just getting started. Look at this brutality.
This is how you torture your opponent.
Oh my God, this is hard to watch. And they just busted out an impactful maneuver. Oh, man, what a shining wizard. He's getting a little fatter now.
That does a chicken wing into a face buster.
Both wrists captured it. Oh my goodness. There's the bully. Right to the face.
Oh man. Standing moonsault gets all of it.
And that is not supposed to look
he's
that easy.
Those
one counts getting harder and harder to kick out of.
And he is now in a discouraging spot.
Yeah, but he's always one counter away from changing things.
Wrapping the arm over that top rope.
Attacking the arm.
Trying to take away that grip, that range of motion on that end. Oh, guys, watch this. Taking athleticism with a 450.
It takes a certain level of athleticism to pull that off.
Just kicks out.
He really thought that was it.
They still, bro. Now you can't control him with 15 security, bro. See how they shot that?
Able to go
like
behind,
a movie.
Whoa, just floating through the air. He's feeling the effects of that last hit.
You know Dakota Kai is only there to speak English.
Big clothesline. Stopped in their tracks with a knee to the gut. Arm sits, and look at these series of boots. Every strike more devastating than the last.
Hey, look at my jobber go. Tell you, them jobbers be putting in work. Just like a movie, just gonna hold that. Welcome, welcome. Just hanging. Jay Cargill.
Super high. And you gotta think he's just one final blow away from not kicking out next time.
If this works, it could change the course of the match.
Pick your jaw up off the floor.
Oh, and he doesn't connect.
Wrist clutch applied. How humiliating. Just kicks to the face. It finds a counter. Boom, kick connects.
This superstar looks to be upping the ante.
Who are you fighting?
Into a fisherman suplex. Nicely done. Two.
Match.
Grabbing the win in this one is a serious accomplishment. To quote a pair of awesome scholars,
that's pretty cool, so I put them on Friday show too.
And there are losers. We are looking at a winner right now.
I can't wait to the end of the show. I want to see what's going to happen at the end of the show. See something go down. Seconds, I'm just booking my matches, I'm the booker.
I don't have a Jim Ross. Jim Ross ain't here.
AI media system to take notes and generate a summary, so Gary doesn't miss a meeting and
Wonder she couldn't get in there. That didn't matter. I'm like, why is she not going in this match? And this up was up. Forgot I switched her from a different roster. No wonder she kept fighting the same girl. That was weird. Alright, I'm good. No, I think it'll work.
Friday.
matches.
Sorry.
For me in this game, you gotta pick the matches that you don't want to bug out or do the weird stuff like a ladder match with like 5 people, 6 people. Sometimes it never finishes. So you gotta do it like one person. Steel cage matches, you better off doing one-on-one. I notice I'm stuck in certain aspects of the game. You just gotta know what to use. Or customize matches the best way you can. This way you know it's a guaranteed end. With the nightmare in the back.
And just hammering away with the rights. Now this is just a ruthless attack. Such aggression. A face buster knee smash.
That looks painful.
Oh my goodness, nasty line. Ah, knee smashing the face. Kick to the stomach. Look at this. And a big knee drop. Oh, he knew what was coming.
Here comes my goal.
These backstage brawls, they could, like, this could be their like, you could put a time limit of max of like 2 minutes. They brawl, and then two referees come out and pull them apart. That would be the cut here. That's what they should do right here.
Punch connects.
That would be a good way to end the cut here. And then you could just add that into any part of your showcase whenever you're ready to.
Setting it up. Thunderous clothesline. Well,
my man,
chilling.
That'll turn your lights out. To the arm. Working on their arm.
Oh, how about a punch?
Seth against Solo, 10:34. Let's see your time this finish.
Oh, stop, stop, stop. Followed by a forearm smash.
we know what's coming next. Perched on the shoulders. Please stay down.
Looks like you get your wish, Saxton. This brawl is over.
Got it. Cards real quick on Friday show.
I don't know, but
I'm excited for WrestleMania. I just want to see what happens.
Are you guys ready?
This is my Friday show. I call it Pulse.
The following contest is a Falls Count Anywhere match. Making his way to the ring from Paris, France.
I just gave a random name when I made him.
Took my spot here at the commentary table. I have wanted to call this match. I cannot wait to finally do it.
I like people like this because they remind me of like William Regal. They're all the way it's set up. It's like, yeah, I like them, so I always look for a character like that.
A man who always considers himself
pretty good
main
though.
Event material, an uncrowned champion. He wants to show exactly why here tonight.
He comes!
And his opponent, representing the Cruise from Albany, New York, weighing in at 258 pounds,
The arena's buzzing, social media's buzzing, a big fight feel and a main event level match.
This is one of my creations from my people.
A man who always gets a strong reaction from the WWE Universe, and it will only intensify once the bell rings.
match is underway. Falls count anywhere. No DQs, no countouts, no escape.
Only two ways to end this match, pin or submission. It doesn't matter where or what you use to accomplish that. We've seen some inventive wins over the years. Who knows what we'll see here?
Nasty! The hardest part of the ring. Many a match has turned on that kind of contact with the apron. This could be a key moment in this contest. Nowhere to go. What's he hoping to find down there?
He's got a sledgehammer. Oh, man, this is not going to end well. Oh, basically hammering their opponent into the floor. And the damage is just going to keep on coming if you can't find a defense for this. This is just getting uncomfortable at this point.
And it is clear the mission now is to destroy and incapacitate. This is an incessant attack being brought to him.
Yeah, now he has to devise a way back into this. What's the biggest risk in a false count anywhere match?
I'd say a false sense of security. Oftentimes in a standard match, you can roll out of the ring when you're in trouble, but that's not the case here. You need to treat every setting like it's high risk.
From the top! Elbow drop! Good lord! He's going for the pin! This could be it! Into the pay window! And he fights it off.
I am in shock. What's it going to take to keep this guy down?
Ouch! Leg breaker. He's definitely being the aggressor here.
He can't allow himself to let up now.
Inverted atomic drop. Ooh. He's looking a little weary now.
But you have to admit, at this point in a falls count anywhere match, there's no way you didn't expect things to be going much, much worse for him, Cole.
My goodness, is this even legal?
I don't think so.
He didn't go in though.
Look at this ruthlessness in the bottom turnbuckle. Will it be?
It's different flavors. I like different flavors. Cheers. Ref went over there like, damn, bro, you good. Hurt himself before WrestleMania.
From Michigan.
Oh, the body. Wow.
competing at such a high level. I predict one of the most competitive matches we've seen in a very long time.
She knows she deserves to be atop this division, and a win tonight will go a long way towards that.
Solo hell no.
See what she can do.
And from Las Vegas, Nevada,
this superstar doesn't get paid by the minute. They just get in there, beat somebody up, and leave.
That's kind of a miserable existence, if you ask me.
I don't see what's so miserable about that, Byron. But then again, I see this superstar for who they are, not your projections.
She's been training for this match for quite a while, and she plans on making a statement here tonight.
The bell rings on the submission match, and guys, you don't see one of these every day. A very unusual match for a very unusual kind of competitor. You can only win this match by making your opponent submit. Oh, and a forearm smash. Uh-oh. High angle belly to back suplex. Now, this is just a ruthless attack.
Oh, such aggression.
And with an onslaught of strikes. Suicide! Tornado DDT! Like a heat-seeking missile, hit the target right on the mark. Submissions are such a tricky thing, Corey. Would you rather play the long game and wear someone down or try to get the quick victory? Not a lot of superstars can notch an instant tap out, so the long game is the way to go for me. It's important to be patient, conserve your strength, but not pass up opportunities as they come. Each hold applied is a step closer to victory. And now gets tossed into the ring. She did her homework there. DDT! Back punch! Ouch!
10:49.
Reversal! What a counter!
And the handspring cardiac kick.
That maneuver goes to show you how much speed kills. Stopped them in their tracks with a kick to the gut. Big knee to the midsection. A mounting. And hammering away.
basically never-ending blows coming at full force here. And the forearm smash. Stomping their opponent.
Oh, what a forearm. Oh, look at this. Oh, kicks. Oh, man.
Good grief.
Turn your lights out. Just going all out with every blow. Oh, that backfired on her. Loving blow. Oh! Oh my God, a moonsault! Oh my gosh, what impact! Oh, stop, stop, stop!
And the forearm smash!
Setting it up! Look at this.
He's going back for a table again. I'm dead.
Tap.
She's losing some steam now.
And you have to wonder how all this is going to come into play down the line.
Pulling in, and what a harsh elbow. And she's been brought to a disadvantage now. Yeah, she's having issues fighting back. Tossed back into the ring. Oh my God, a moonsault. Setting it up. Oh, this is going to be nasty. Oh, I had that well scouted, but she has to push now while the window's open.
Oh, boy. Here it comes. Will she get it fully locked in?
Putting the pressure on.
She will not quit. She will not stop fighting.
Needed a midsection. Bang to the neck. She's trying so desperately to get back up to her feet. Making sure her opponent remembers who the better superstar is. Inverted atomic drop. Oh, what a kick. Oh, that was nasty.
Arm pull. Bring on the arm into the side suplex. Complete shot.
Bloodline rules. Jay Uso.
Incoming. Bicycle knee strike. Here it is, the Dragon Sleeper.
Dragon Sleeper locked in deep.
Say goodnight. Oh, nowhere to go. Nowhere. Not sure why, but she releases the hold.
Well, I think she sensed her opponent was about to break free.
See if he gets speared right.
Springboard moonsault. Headlock, elbow drop.
Ooh.
She's bringing the
pressure on.
Really taking control here.
Come here, boy.
Stopping their opponent.
Oh, what a forearm smash.
Yeah, the final loss. Yeah, the Rock is hilarious. Let's see if Cody shows up and try and get retaliated.
The target's been acquired once more. There's the cover. Close the book on this one. We have seen such a physical match from these combatants, and the wear and tear is starting to show. And now the time where the smartest competitor needs to take advantage of the situation. Needs to figure out the quickest way to end this. Nasty stomp of the arm. And she may be getting pushed beyond her limit. And you have to imagine she can't tough things out for much longer.
Didn't I call it? Didn't I say Cody? Let's see if Cody gonna show up.
Attack from behind. Textbook neckbreaker.
You can tell she wants to put an end to this.
Kind of knew this was coming.
With a knuckle sandwich. Oh, right across the solar plexus. Oh, drop right across the neck. Now, here we go. Beautiful. Oh, swinging neckbreaker.
And she's really being knocked around here. She has to rely on her instincts to turn things around.
Yeah, this is funny as hell.
Boom!
This is what you call high risk, high reward.
Look at her stumble back up. Promising double vision.
I knew Roman was still there. I knew Roman was
crashing down with high impact.
Because I saw reports that they were going to like do something to get the Rock, but I knew Roman was going to stay around.
Is the mark.
That's what nobody expects.
In the midsection, into the pump handle. Here we go. X Factor. And that is all she wrote. Listen to this place. It's electric.
Yo, it's so bad they call it CM Punk. Why are you calling it CM Punk? He ain't helping now. Bloodline set the trap, not them.
You can see her struggling to find her.
Bloodline set the trap.
My friends, we have reached the bitter end.
Damn, he went through Cody. I knew Bloodline was Let's get it.
Rolls through and a kick right to the spine. Scraping over the eyes. Oh boy, that's a determined stand.
There was reports that Cody and Seth was going to retaliate and set a trap for a Rock. So that's why Roman was like, call me if you need me. Yeah, I knew.
And the WWE Universe continues to remain. She will not quit. She will not stop. There's the sling blade and a basement drop kick. Stopping their opponent. Forearm smash. Springboard. Phoenix splash. You gotta be kidding me.
Damn. Seth fell that one.
Keeping in close quarters, and look at these lefts.
Now this is just a ruthless attack.
Oh, such aggression. This is nothing short of disturbing. Oh, so frightening. So bizarre, so eerie. Welcome to get worse to Sister.
This is where they're showing the ruthlessness.
Will that be it? Will that be enough? Uh-oh, guys, this could be over. No escape.
Put your kids to bed.
The submission match is over.
Put your kids to bed. This is ruthlessness.
Victory here.
Getting it done the hard way.
I have a lot of respect for the performance she just gave in this match. She earned this win, no question.
Shit. Fuck your story. Yo, this is personal. Yo, that was crazy. Yeah. Rock said one more time. Rock said one more time before the cameras come off. He looked around too. He looked at everybody and said, you know what? One more time. Yo, that was crazy. Put your kids to bed after 10 when WWE is on. Oh my god. They went hard. See, I knew that Seth and Cody had the trap because there was rumors about that. But nobody thought about the Bloodline having a trap of their own for the trap. Mm. Call me if you need me. Alright, see you later. They smart, bro. That was fun. I knew that. I knew Roman didn't leave. WrestleMania on Saturday. They eat it, we be crazy. Just going back enjoying the steak. Waiting for the right time. They got whooped.
Here comes trouble.
For all that, they gotta have reinforcements.
The following contest is a tag team extreme rules match. And at a combined weight of 418 pounds.
If Cody's gonna win the title, that makes him look real good that he's not gonna win the title. You lashing me like that today? I might not make it on the air. Them shit's connected.
They are ready for a fight.
And that belt is heavy. That was crazy.
And there's sure to be plenty of bedlam on tap in this Extreme Rules matchup.
These superstars have nothing but bad intentions in mind for each other. And they have everything and everywhere at their disposal to annihilate one another.
Oh, ruthless.
I think rage took over in that moment. Nothing but blind rage.
Out of the ring. What's his plan here?
Any chance of taking it?
be set up for a lovely spread. Never mind, that never happens. Someone is likely going through. Oh, no. Well, goodbye to his opponent, at least temporarily on the outside of the ring. Here he comes.
And he goes for the pin.
Welcome. What up, homie? I was just like watching the game.
It's a chance to think outside the box and inflict some truly inventive pain on your opponent. It's also a chance to be on the receiving end of that inventive pain. But you're right, Corey. Getting creative could be the best way to get ahead of this match. I'm telling your opponent, you don't deserve to share this stage with me. Heads out and he has all the time he wants.
I guess we chill. Watching these characters
relenting with these knee strikes, showing absolutely no mercy at all. What an onslaught.
Right out of ringside and back to the mat. He's looking for an implement of destruction under the ring.
A second gut wrench suplex.
You have to be in peak physical condition to pull off a move with that much weight behind it.
Straight move.
He's lost some of his wind now. By throwing an elbow into the midsection. What grace! Float over into the DDT!
Good grief, man! This is vicious!
That was a vicious display. You can almost see the disdain in their eyes. Ha, ha, ha! Big boot! And look at front back suplex! Very nice. Ooh, well planted knee!
Ouch!
He'll head to the ring. Something, anything under the ring.
The steel chair looks like he's opted to go with the simple but effective statement here.
The close of this match is just ahead.
Yeah, this is not good.
You don't say, Saxton. Oh, knee right to the face. Oh! Counters that.
Double knee back.
Slides him back to the mat. And now thrown back into the ring.
Let's see what the other podcasters thought about that segment. And that's what's great.
He's outside the ring now.
Hope he's got a plan. Wow, the power that takes is insane. Tell he's feeling it now. This fight is pumping him up.
The face has been planted. And there was some force on that move. He's on his heels a bit now.
Showing a lot of fortitude in this Extreme Rules match for sure, but not sure how much more tenable it could be. Knee strike.
Yo, what if that was like the preview of Netflix version of what WWE
back into the ring.
What if they're about to make it so intense that it has to be on like something like that?
Yeah.
bad for Cody. Like, damn, bro. You doing all this for a story? Rock yourself. Get story in the middle. I'm about to do it, bro. Like, this shit was personal. Awesome.
Some tough hits now.
In order to succeed in an extreme rules match, you have to be willing to sacrifice your body a bit, guys. Able to reverse that one.
Get to the midsection. Seth Rollins. Looking for the victory.
He's just created a perfect opportunity. He just won't give up.
Makes the cover. And he stops the count for his partner. He steps foot in the ring again. Oh.
Sports and sports entertainment. This is a duo that really practiced their teamwork.
Martin's on also.
There you go.
This is it, guys. The title is up for grabs here.
And this might be the most highly anticipated title defense in recent memory.
The challenger looks to be in the best shape ever, ready to compete for that title.
As a reminder, the title is on the line here in this match.
And the champ is certainly going to have an uphill battle, that's for sure.
She is determined to stay atop the division. We'll see if she can do just that.
Introducing the challenger from Detroit, Michigan, Jay.
You can see it in everyone's eyes. They all want this championship. This right here is a championship that gained a lot of prestige in short order, guys.
Yeah, I mean, once a title match is called by yours truly, you know it finally matters in our industry.
Well, you're certainly not Mr. Modest today, are you, Corey?
Oh, the bell clap from behind.
Not the position you want to be in right now. Check your face after that one. Heads out of the ring. What's next?
Street slam.
Boom. Oh, kick right to the gut.
Another one.
Clothesline. Play impossible.
Whoa.
Play impossible. The champion with a quick shoulder up.
I think this ref might be a little slow on the count.
Yeah. Oh, smashing the jaw.
Oh, a stomp right to the chest. Are you kidding me?
Off the ropes.
Brutal knee to the side of the face. Now, this is the kind of match where you can really push the bounds of damage you can inflict. I'm not saying that a no disqualification match should mean carte blanche to do whatever you want to someone, but it does provide an opening to be creative in your offense. So be creative.
Rolling into a monkey flip. The champion just chucking the competition around like they're nothing. That has to claw at the challenger in some way.
Chop block!
Targeted the lower body there, and it was highly effective.
She returns the favor there. Wow, that won't separate your shoulder. That'll divorce it.
Drop kick hits the mark.
That says it all, guys. Champ says you are not worthy.
Talk about dismantling your opponent.
A jumping headbutt. She's sent back in under the ropes. Oh my God, fails to connect on the springboard.
Right to the leg. She's firing up, no doubt about it.
My goodness, did you hear that shot? Nice Japanese on drag.
Dominating.
Oh, new champ. And a shoulder in the air. She likely knew that wasn't enough. She's just keeping the pressure on. Heads out of the ring. What's next?
Big bat in tow. And she has plans to take a swing at the opposition.
The champ not looking great right now.
Yeah, but you can't count anyone out yet. This match could still go either way. This is getting more and more alarming with each uninterrupted attack.
And you never want to count a competitor out, but there seems to be no signs of defense right now. And it's getting downright nastier and nastier with each of these attacks.
An agile escape.
Got the front face lock applied. Nice suplex.
Just a tenacious assault from her.
Yeah, she continues to maintain the leverage here.
Elbow drop. And now she delivers her back into the ring.
She's going.
From the top rope, diving elbow drop! She's about to rise up to something catastrophic. To the back of the knee.
The title's in jeopardy here.
I think the paradigm has shifted.
For sure. The title still hanging in the balance.
Resilience of a champion on display. And you see a perplexed kick connect. Hooking it up.
Rose plant. We can have a new champion.
Cover. Two. We got a new champion. Unbelievable.
Here is your winner. Hybrid fighting champion, Jade Madison.
She's done it. Won herself the title.
Honestly, Michael, there is no way I can think to describe this other than absolute goosebumps.
Then imagine how the new champ must feel, Byron.
Sorry, I'm playing with something new.
We are about to see something good.
The following is a Falls Count Anywhere match. Making his way to the ring from Yonkers, New York, weighing in at 230 pounds, the Grand Prix International Champion, Adam Hatcher!
This right here is a no-nonsense superstar.
More like a no-respect superstar. They should thank the higher-ups once in a while.
Don't you call yourself the savior of misbehavior?
This isn't about me. That's neither here nor there, Cole.
The champ was actually asking for this to be a title match, but the officials backstage wouldn't allow it. That is how competitive he is.
Single negative thing backstage about this superstar.
Well, that's what happens when you treat your fellow superstars with respect. They respect you right back.
There are no awards for congeniality here in WWE. That respect means nothing if you lose. He's in perhaps the best physical condition of his life. He knows what it takes to reach the top here in WWE.
Falls Count Anywhere match is now underway. No way of knowing where these superstars could end up taking this fight.
The outside, backstage, the parking lot, heck, even the Raptors are in play now. I doubt it will be pretty, but I can promise you this match will be pretty interesting.
Taking
taking this to the outside now. He's reaching under the ring for anything useful.
We've seen the sledgehammer many times before, and it has never been a pretty sight.
Oh, mat slam
with some attitude.
Watch this. Northern Lights. And into the count. Quick shoulder up.
Maybe that was just to keep his opponent off balance.
Everything in this match is legal, and we have cameras all over the arena. So wherever these superstars' imagination takes them, you won't miss any of the action. And you need a limitless imagination to win a match like this. You have to stay on the attack because fortunes can change with just one move.
Yeah, especially in a situation where a limitless amount of real estate is your battleground.
Oh, look, here's a cover. Fending off a two count there.
I didn't think this match was close to over.
He is revving up the engine. He's not going to let anything stop him.
Oh, from behind, that'll give you some whiplash.
Setting up for something here.
No. Power bomb out of the apron.
The damage he's taking is starting to pile up.
Turning the tables.
Big ball.
Strike, guys. What are we gonna see?
Yeah.
Big time knee, lariat combo.
Oh, colliding with a barricade. Boom.
Oh man, he has fired up now.
Finishing off this match.
Clearly hoping something nefarious is beneath the ring.
One more after.
Guarantee that chair is not going to be used as it was designed for.
I was more watching Monday Night Raw. It's
still hanging on.
We'll see if this is the start of a rally. Punches to the ear? How are they going to hear after this match?
And any one of those shots could take you out for good. That kick will stop you in your tracks. Shifts it back onto it.
Yikes, that'll either wake you up or knock you out.
Just punched him right in the mouth. Relentless.
Enough already. Been here before, and he knows what he needs to do.
The wind up and the pitch. Uppercut. What a punch! Oh, what a big uppercut! And he's pulled the ring apron up, looking under there for something. Oh, a horrific crack in the back. Just a ghastly shot.
You can see the anguish growing on his face.
Uh-oh.
Oh, driver.
Spiked him.
He's already spending that winner's purse.
For the win. There's two. No, my, that was close.
I do not know how they got up from that.
Operating on pure instinct and adrenaline right now.
I've lost count of how many times this match should have ended by now.
What are we about to see?
Ah, crush a hamstring. Turning the momentum to his favor.
Things are really going his way now.
So much damage inflicted.
Punches to the ear? How are they going to hear after this match?
He's going for the pin. This could be it.
Oh,
this victory tonight.
They are riding high on this win. This celebration might carry on the rest of the month.
Guess what? By 86-87, he was playing left field for the Kansas City Royals. And then on a lark in the fifth, sixth rounds of the 87 draft, Al Davis said, you know what? Let's pick that left fielder. 5 months later, he has a new hobby. So again, this could be done. But I'm just saying, do you have the character and do you have the wherewithal to be a Vincent Bo Jackson?
So Deion, in that interview, said a couple other things. He indicated, he mentioned San Francisco, Dallas, Washington, Baltimore, and then he added this quote. There were certain cities, and he's talking about himself, there were certain cities that fit for me. Atlanta fit, and I want that for my team, all of them. I want the right fit. Atlanta was the first time I saw black people in positions of authority. It blew my mind. It was real in Atlanta. I had never seen anything like that in my life. And so I guess that's why he's including Washington and Baltimore on this list. D.C. and Baltimore about his top.
The following contest is a submission match. The Heavyweight Championship!
Are you guys ready?
Ladies and gentlemen, as a reminder, the championship is on the line here tonight.
And in looking at the opposition, I can say that the champion will have quite the hill to climb in this one.
Take a look in his eyes. More than ready to become the standard bearer of this division.
All right, I love this guy.
Incredibly competent, Corey.
And with good reason, Cole. When you're the champ, you don't have to worry about winning. You just have to make sure you don't lose. That is the champion's advantage.
We're putting the title on the line.
Introducing the challenger from Knoxville, Tennessee, weighing in at 204
bump, you know what I mean?
A fully confident challenger in their corner, absolutely hell-bent on capturing the title.
Pretty, pretty cool. You remind me of Braun Breaker.
You'll have to forgive me for the lack of information on this title, but I have heard that it's highly...
Kicks the leg of their opponent, steps through. Here we go! Rolling deathlock!
Rolling deathlock! And he releases the hold.
I don't think he had it fully locked in.
Give me some shit if he can't break.
We're on the horizon. Oh! Knee drop.
Grabbing the arms and just rapid stops. Just stomping every single part of the body. The title on the line, the champ isn't holding anything back. Challenger eating up some damage.
He was waiting for him to make his move. Into the lariat.
Clothesline. It's all about your technical ability in a submission match. That has to restrict some superstars.
You'd be surprised, Cole. Submission and holds are some of the most basic mat tenets. Just because a superstar doesn't rely on them doesn't mean they're alien to them.
Flying Marana!
That's how you impress. That kind of agility is what earned them the title. Oh! Knee drop!
Measuring! Oh! Face stop! Dropping the knee!
With the WWE Universe right now.
The running Meteora. This is making me nervous.
Oh, man! Slingshot DDT off the apron.
Oh, stop, stop, stop. Followed by a forearm smash.
Oh, knee drop.
Uh-oh. Oh, flipping the script on him there. Oh, what a knee lift.
Somebody better check his nose.
Arms trapped. Just unloading knees to the body. The challenger looked unhinged with an absolutely uncorked attack on the champ there.
Fought off with an elbow.
What are you waiting for? Get back in there.
You tell him, Saxton.
Gets put into the barricade. Able to evade.
Cutting off the count in the nick of time. What a shot. An endless bombardment from the champion. The challenger has to be rocked. Kick right to the gut. Seated bionic elbow. The challenger's hopes are slipping away. Yeah, this is a dire situation right now. Nice hip toss.
He's getting fired up now, really feeding off this crowd.
Check out this.
All the way down. The champ's eyes look good.
And look at this now. Yes, applying the submission hold.
And the sleeper hold is firmly applied, trying to turn out the light. Look at this, he let it go.
Curious decision there, Michael.
Hammering down on the knee.
boost right now from all those chants and cheers.
Look at this, just unloading.
Oh, a nasty stop to finish it off.
Saw that one coming, took advantage.
Oof. Rolling through, not finished yet.
Here it comes.
Driven down hard.
German suplex.
Those last hits rattled the champ.
Yeah, Cole, and now's the time you need to slap a submission on your opponent before they get one on you.
He's lining him up. Cut off with a kick to the gut.
Caught in the electric chair, but fighting.
Fighting desperately to find a way out, and they do.
A follow-away slam.
Caught by the back of the elbow.
Springboard moonsault.
He is fired up now.
Oh, man, right to the arm.
Hyperextend your elbow.
Something ominous is looming. Looking to end this one.
Bicycle knee strike.
The title's going nowhere.
Oh, no, he can be caught here. Bad spot for him.
Trying to take an arm out of the socket here.
They want that, and they are not letting go.
And he chooses to let go of the hold.
But just the amount of time he was in that submission could be very significant.
Oh, knee drop.
This has become a monumental clash. There are no breaks on these competitors.
The will, the fire, the guts. You can feel their emotion.
Oh, look at this. Oh, kicks.
Capped off with a big one.
Man, knee strike.
Both wrists captured, a brutal knee right to the face. Uh-oh. Batten down the hatches.
F5! Thunderous!
The title might change hands.
Oh, it's soon. We could be seeing a submission here.
Got him in the sleeper. Is he going to pass out? He's in.
Got it. New champion.
Here is your winner. And new
heavyweight
champion, Tomahawk Nelson.
I still can't believe it.
There you see our new champion.
He dug deep into his offensive arsenal and played defense at the right time. And now the title is his.
Got a new champion.
Monday Night Raw was a hit, and it was awesome. I was tired. Tomorrow's NXT. I'm gonna go get me something to eat. And some old business. We got some more characters I can get, but close to finishing, the roster. Then I could copy the universe. Man, always a pleasure. Thank you for joining. Thank you for viewing. Thank you for liking. Thank you for taking a peek. I appreciate your company. I won't even say time, but the company. I just like the company while I stream.
Why not?
Ain't nothing else to do, right? So when I stream, I need some company. So I appreciate it. Anyway, have a good night. See y'all tomorrow for NXT. Stay tuned. Later.
I know you're gonna dig this.
Hear this!